Hey everybody, it's 40Ware. Welcome back to Ninja Gaiden Black. Took care of chapter 1 in the first part, and we're on our way to chapter 2 and seeing what the hell is going on with the Hayabusa Village. Now that first chapter was... don't forget about that trap door. That first chapter went about 19 minutes. Most of the chapters will run... chapters can run anywhere from like 10 minutes to over an hour. So... I'll have vids that can cover a whole chapter, and I'll have other vids that cover maybe a fifth of a chapter, depending on what's going on. And also depending on how much creative editing I want to do. But that, well, obviously I can control one of the things, but the one thing I can't control is how I, well, I can control that too, but I can't control as much how things go. I mean, because even I don't know. When I play this, I can range anywhere from great to almighty suckage in, really, in no time flat. You saw some of the battles, I was playing terrible. Even that Mirai fight, I wasn't doing too well. So, really, I mean, yeah, well, enough about creative editing. This is the Art of the Fire Wheels. It is a Ninpo, our first one. Now, you always want to equip it so you can use it. Now, if I hit Y and B, I can summon fire wheels around me. Very useful, but as you see, only one use. And then after that, it's like, whatever. It's good if you want to protect yourself, but, I mean, that's really only against melee. Enemies that shoot, that have guns or whatever, you really, it's a little limited in that regard. Smoke bombs, the single most useless item in the game. It does absolutely nothing. It shoots a puff of smoke. Yeah, sure, but... also... hey, Samurai. Stop kicking my ass. And these guys are way tougher than the ninjas I was fighting in Chapter 1. And these guys are giving me a hard time. Jeez. So yeah, that was a very bad fight. That went horribly. Good lord. And we'll also meet a second enemy, that guy right there who shoots that. But luckily, he goes down quickly and he gives you a lot of health because he's considered difficult thanks to his hadoukening. Yes, I just turned hadouken into a verb. What of it? Little note. If you're blocking, you cannot absorb essence. So bear that in mind as you're playing through this game. If you have blue health around you, you're gonna have to unblock to get it. So you gotta have to find yourself a little time window so you can absorb the health and get back to blocking as need be. The swimming is very stiff. It's not great mechanics, but thankfully you don't swim frequently, so. Oh yeah, he can run across water. Something something reused Jesus, right? Yeah. Of course not. And pretty pathetically, but there is a chest here, so I guess it's a good thing I did go back. Hey. I can get up, right? Come on. I'll probably show off running across water at a different time. Right now, though, it's kind of unimportant. I want that item pretty badly. I don't know why, I just want it badly. And especially if it's a healing item, because... oh, that's probably how I get it. Okay. Let's try it. Ready? Get set. Ta-da! Life of the Gods. Remember Life of the Thousand Gods? Well, this is the watered-down version of it. Pun not intended. If you get 9 of these, you can raise your health. So, yeah. They are pretty valuable items as well. And here at the Hayabusa Village, we're going to be facing, well, a lot of destruction, evidently. And as you see, the camera's facing off center a little bit, so there's probably bad guys around.
Oh, that was perfect timing there.
God damn, I didn't want to absorb that one. Enemies can be very adept at guarding too, so trying to find a window can be tough. But some techniques like that are generally unblockable. Another reason why the ultimate technique rules. And that guy just gave me a spiritual elixir, so. Yep, that's a good thing. And this guy here has nothing. Statue head, though. This goes to here because there was, if you're a ninja and aware of your surroundings, there was a severed head. And what do you know? A second life of the gods. You could always use that. That up here is a cracked rock. A very strong impact. We don't have a very strong impact or blunt object. Yeah. This is the lunar. Bow staff. So if you want to channel your inner Donatello, this is what you would use. Generally, not very powerful. Not very powerful, but the strength of it obviously is the range. You can create some decent combos with it, but not great combos. And the damage just does not match up to other weapons. So in reality, I think the lunar is not a very useful weapon. And it looks like Ayane got taken down in the attack too, but she can't die because she's important to us.
A dark samurai.
Not a lover though. Don't get that idea.
Black armor, master. You do not attempt to fight it.
We get the bow. This projectile weapon is quite useful and will give you a lot of uses throughout. It's much more powerful than a shuriken. It'll probably kill most enemies in 2 or 3 blows. As opposed to a shuriken, which might take you, you know, a couple decades to kill anything. This here is a Muramasa statue. These are your shops. So you got the shop here, that's pretty basic. Arrows. I don't really need them right now. The wooden sword, this is interesting. It's a very pathetic weapon, but it does have its use. The Art of Inferno is epic. You really want this. You get the blacksmith who can upgrade your weapons at certain points. Now, if you wanted to play this with the wooden sword, you can actually upgrade it, but most weapons you can upgrade 2 or 3 once or twice, so get to level 3. This you can upgrade up to like level 7, but it costs a ton of essence to do it, but it does give you access to one of the most powerful swords in the game if you do it, so it's kind of like a carry item in that regard, but it's purely optional. And honestly, I don't think it's worth the essence to do it, because you're talking a ton of essence here. Essence you could use for like talismans or whatever. As you see, talismans are not very cheap. Either are great devil elixirs, which you don't have to worry about now, or great spirit elixirs at 5,000, which are quite expensive too. You can talk to this guy, and if you talk to him, well, he tells you about this special currency, this special collectible, which gives you access to some really awesome items. Of course, we don't have them at this point. So, no sense in me fretting over that. Also, I want the Art of the Inferno. As you see, it has levels too. There's 2 more spells I can learn, and they all can be upgraded to level 3. The Art of Fire Wheels is the exception to the rule. But the Inferno is actually a very powerful item. And one that I'll actually use quite frequently. Ah, dang you. Put your frickin' hadouken. No to that. I say no to hadoukens. Only Ryu can use hadoukens, and not this Hayabusa. Not Hayabusa, I'm talking about that other Ryu. Yes, he's other Ryu to me. Why? Because I don't play Street Fighter, or Mortal Kombat, or anything like that. Why? Because I really don't care for the games too much, and I suck at them too. Probably good reason. You tend to not like a game if you suck at it. Never use comrades, but shot through with arrows. Although the thought of destroying dead bodies is unpleasant, you can use these things. So, you can carry 15 arrows at a time. All items have limits to how many you can carry. A spiritual elixir, 10. Great spirit elixirs, 5. Talismans, 3. And right now we have horsemen. Or horsemen, as you prefer. Now, the trick is they want you to use this. If you get lucky enough to knock the samurai down, well, you can speed this fight up drastically. However, the practicality of it is just, well, it's very tough in practice to do. So I usually opt for a... Ooh, got him. Well, that's awesome. I usually opt for plan B, which is slap the horse. Of course, you get lucky enough to get this. The spearmen are much easier to do this with than the bowmen, for obvious reasons. And I'm not in good shape. Ah, freak, that was an easy shot. I missed it. Bow is not the easiest thing to use. I mean, you can aim it relatively well, but the issue with it just lies in getting time to use it. That's really the only thing I can say about it. What I'm doing right now probably is not the recommended strategy, but I want hits. Hey. God damn you. Got him, nice. Down. Give me more arrows, because with a spearman I have an easier shot at hitting this guy. Ooh, got him. How about that? There we go. Not a very good fight there. And look at my health. Ugh. That is not good. But you ready for the good news? Eh, 3 should be manageable. I'm not very pleased, though, with that fight. The good news is the boss is right there. So, yeah, I can beat this chapter very quickly, too. Up there, there's no real reason to go up there at this point. So don't worry about that. I do like that, though. So now we have our weapons going into this next boss fight. And I forget the boss's name. That part escapes me. And this guy will have henchmen. The hadoukening guys. But anyway, this bastard, just like before, really. That was almost like a warm-up fight. But there's two ways you can really handle this. The bow is probably the way the game sort of designs you to do it, but well, there's other ways. One thing about having henchmen is they give you essence, which means you can translate it into ultimate techniques, which you can use to devastate bosses, like so. Oh jeez, I'm about to die. That's what I mean about devastating. Oh, I also got a red thing out of that, evidently. So I got my Nimpo back. Oh, I got it again. Oh, jeez. I am not having a good go at this. That worked. Yeah, the bow's working actually pretty well. Ooh, it worked extremely well. Wow, the bow worked a lot better than I gave it credit for. If only I did that from the beginning. Technique scroll, counterattacks. Definitely helpful, because now an enemy strikes, I can hit the X or Y, and maybe, you know, knock them down. Which can be quite awesome. But after that quite pathetic showing... yeah. That was pretty pathetic, I will say that. Definitely did not handle my business there. Used too many healing items and whatnot. But I got away with it, so. Badass. I want to do that face for Halloween. Act like I have fire going through my face and it being clear. Because that looks sick. Did say, do not attempt to fight him. But however, Ryu Hayabusa is badass. He can't die in this. So, we all know that he's just heavily wounded. He's not gonna die. That is the conclusion of chapter 2, 15 minutes. If I had my Ninpo, I would get points for that, but alas, I didn't. Probably got like Lester or something like that. Head ninja again. Alright, whatever. I got Master last time.
My network of ninja have uncovered the reason for the attack. The samurai who burned the village was Doku, lord of the greater fiends of the Vigor Empire. It appears as though the Vigor Emperor seeks the power of the Dark Dragon Blade.
So now we got a name to a face, or should I say a flaming head or a hot head. Chapter 3, Skies of Vengeance. The Hayabusa Village is burned and the Dark Dragon Blade is gone. Ryu is stowed aboard an airship headed for the Vigor Empire. His goal? Vengeance. Kind of simple. Nothing about the Dark Dragon Blade, though. That part's just secondary, I guess.
A strange dictatorship veiled in secrecy. Its exclusionist foreign policy makes for very few ways to enter the country. One of the only remaining routes is by airship to the capital city of Tyrone.
Maintain current course and velocity. I repeat, maintain current course and velocity.
Well, that's a good thing. Now Ryu has to go fight the Vigor army to gain passage. Well, anyway, that will wait until the next time. So, see you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.